Minister LeBlanc, you're a highly experienced parliamentarian, and you know very well that we've had terms like leader of the government, leader of the opposition, whip, and recognized party in the Senate and in many other parliamentary systems and jurisdictions for decades, and sometimes for centuries. Yet one of the main features of this bill, S4, is the entrenching of brand new nomenclature in the Parliament of Canada Act, our governing legislation. And what is basically brand new, historically speaking, are terms that are in Bill S4, like liaison, government representative, facilitator, and parliamentary group. These terms were only first used by some in the Senate a few years ago, since the Trudeau government has been in power. Minister LeBlanc, in Bill S4, none of these brand new terms are even defined in this bill. As such, if this bill passes, the Parliament of Canada Act would not include definitions for any of those terms. And under Bill S4, senators appointed to these undefined positions and in unnamed parliamentary groups will receive significant amounts of taxpayers' dollars on an ongoing basis. Minister LeBlanc, you were a lawyer, a 20-year parliamentarian and legislator, and the minister responsible for this bill. Why aren't any of those terms defined in Bill S4, and what is your government going to do to fix this?
Madam Chair, through you to Senator Batters, thank you for the question. We believe that the Senate is perfectly capable itself to defining those roles in their own rules and for the people that are ultimately appointed to those functions to decide in collaboration with different groups in the Senate and their colleagues in a particular group, for example, the kind of roles that they want to undertake and the work that they want to do. We didn't think it would be particularly prescriptive to have job descriptions, lists of particular functions that these roles would evolve in a way that senators and the Senate itself saw appropriate. Obviously, if the Senate wants to amend the legislation, and there's a consensus in the Senate to add some particular detail into those functions, we don't particularly have a strong view on that. We were told in the discussion with officials of the Department of Justice, for example, that traditionally the Senate itself and the occupants of those roles, based on convention and rules that prescribe the governance of the Senate and its various committees, for example, would be the best place for those precisions to be brought. But if the Senate feels strongly or has a strong views in that direction, obviously we don't have an overwhelming view ourselves, because all of these changes ultimately, Senator Batters, apply to the Senate itself. And that's, as I said in my opening comments, we thought it was important to introduce this government bill in the Senate because it properly affects the functioning of the Senate, the way the Senate wants to structure itself. My own view is that parliamentarians in the House of Commons should very much yield to the Senate the ability to decide how these things should be structured. So we will wait to see what legislation the Senate ultimately adopts. And my job with our House leader will be to see if we can work with other parties in the House of Commons to put the legislation through the House of Commons expeditiously.
Senator Batters?
Thank you. Minister LeBlanc, you held a press conference in December 2015 to announce all of the Trudeau government changes in the quote-unquote nonpartisan independent Senate. You said that day that, quote, we are not going to appoint a government Senate whip because there will be no votes that will be subject to a government whip. We intend to keep this post vacant. So we see the start of a different relationship, quote. You then testified at the Senate Rules Committee 3 months later to try and explain all these newfangled changes to us. You reiterated that day, quote, the function of whip, which again is in the legislation, we won't be whipping votes in the Senate. Our instinct is we probably won't appoint the whip function, quote. When pressed on who would carry out the administrative functions of the government whip, you replied, quote, we thought that those administrative functions could perhaps be assigned to the new deputy government representative, the deputy government leader, quote. Yet, lo and behold, just weeks after that, the Trudeau government appointed a chief government Senate whip. I mean, facilitator. I mean, it's tough to keep track. And then that new, quote-unquote, nonpartisan independent government whip was former Senator Mitchell, who had left the Senate Liberal caucus only 2 days earlier, and who was just as partisan a Liberal as I am a Conservative, and that's actually a good thing. And this whip position and its new Trudeau government-styled name is now further entrenched in Bill S-4. So, Minister LeBlanc, why the major reversal on the vacant Senate whip for the Trudeau government so many months after that promise?
Madam Chair, thank you, Senator, for the question. As you will note, Bill S-4 defines the government representative in the Senate, the legislative deputy to the government representative in the Senate, and the government liaison in the Senate. That is the way that we would propose that those titles be styled. Whatever the particular nomenclature, obviously, as I say, if the Senate wants to amend it and change these titles, it's in the hands of the Senate. We don't think it's constructive because it does not reflect what the Prime Minister in his conversations with me, with Senator Gold and others, spoke about a more independent Senate that doesn't have the government telling individual senators how they should vote on legislation. We think the benefit of independent, learned voices in the Senate has improved, and there are numerous examples in the last parliament and this parliament of where legislation has been improved by the Senate. So we think this evolution is constructive, has been positive. But again, we would be governed by the views of the Senate. But I can tell you the Prime Minister, the House Leader, myself, do not spend our time talking to senators about how they're going to vote on particular pieces of legislation, as would a traditional whip function. Senator Gold participates in an appropriate way with the government in terms of understanding the way we can constructively and properly advance legislation important to the government and to Canadians. But in no way, from my conversations with him, and I know that it's the same for the Prime Minister, is there a discussion around how we can convince certain senators to vote certain ways on particular bills. That traditional whip function is left to the good judgment of senators, and I would think we've had some success in that. But perhaps your question could be at one of the question periods that Senator Gold loves, would be an interesting question to ask him, because he is much more involved, obviously, in these daily conversations than I am. But in no context are we purporting to bring back that particular function. And that's why I would have you note that the name has changed appropriately, we believe.
Senator Batters, you have 2 minutes.
Thank you. Minister LeBlanc, when you were actually asked about the Senate structure for question period in that 2015 press conference, you said this, quote, "They could go to a series of written questions. If they decided that from time to time they wanted ministers to go and participate in a committee of the whole or some other structure, we would be open to that conversation. We're open to figuring out a way that works for them, but there will not be the traditional government leader who was a minister who answered. We don't want it to be a carbon copy of what's down the hall," quote. Minister, the Trudeau government's attitude toward the Senate and accountability can be looked at as dismissive, much like we're a middling government department, not an equal and complementary chamber of parliament. The government Senate leader does not have a permanent Senate seat, a permanent seat at the cabinet table. He sometimes cannot answer questions in question period, opting instead to give delayed answers from your department, Minister, that routinely takes 6 to 8 months. The Trudeau government has told us which ministers we can have for Senate question periods and when they will appear, and it's usually not when they have hot files in their portfolios. So in that initial press conference in December 2015, you indicated that the Prime Minister would not appoint a Senate government leader for another month or month and a half. It did take 5 months, but bygones. In his Bill S-4 speech, former government Senate Leader Harder said the changes in this Bill S-4 were the result of alignment between you as the minister and the government Senate leader. But shouldn't that alignment instead rightfully be between the government Senate leader and the Prime Minister? Now we're enshrining this potentially dysfunctional relationship in the bill before us, S-4. So when will this Trudeau government show the Senate some more respect on this accountability aspect so that we can do our best work for Canadians?
Mr. Minister, you have 25 seconds.
Well, Madam Chair, it obviously won't surprise you that I have a different view than Senator Batters in terms of our respect for the Senate. I would have you note also that Mr. Harper, when he was prime minister, also had at some points a government leader, as he called it, who was also not a cabinet minister. We think we have a function that's respectful and appropriate. We think Senator Gold does very, very good and important work for Canadians. We're proud of these changes. I don't share the pessimism of Senator Batters. I think our experiment has been very appropriate and constructive for Canadians. And we think that the Senate has done and will continue to do very important work. So it shouldn't surprise you, I don't share her pessimism at all.